Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Roslyn Kehamba. If you're here for the first time, make sure you click the subscribe button and also the notification bell so that you don't miss out on anything that comes. And for them that are returning viewers, I appreciate you so much. Thank you for always sharing. Thank you for always liking, viewing, and also for them that comment. Today, I'd like us to look at one discussion question. Is there such a thing as the one meant for you to marry? Many people are stuck on their way to marriage because they are waiting for that particular person that God intended for them to marry, while others are also filled with fear because they think if they make a mistake in the as pertaining the person they were supposed to marry, then their marital life will be doomed. I'd like us to look at it in two sides. That is the side that supports there is a particular person for you to marry, and also the other side that does not support this discussion question. For them that believe there's a particular person for you to marry, their argument originates from the thought that God has predestined us, that before he formed us in our mother's womb, God already knew us, and he knows the plans that he has for us, and that is marriage plans included. Then they also believe that if Eve originated from Adam's rib, then every female, that is every woman, originated from a male somewhere, and for you to be considered to have married well, then you must go and find your rib, that is if it's a man, and as a woman you must kind of find the rib cage where you came from for that marriage to work. And the other side of the coin, that is for them that believe there is no such a thing as the one for you to marry, believe that God is supreme, he's sovereign, however he does not impose his plans on us. He allows us to choose for ourselves. That is, we have the free will to choose what we want. Look at the salvation plan of God. God intended that every mankind be reconciled back to him. However, he did not impose it on us. Joshua was talking to the children of the Israelites, and he told them there are two ways, life and death. Choose which way you want to go. But as for me and my house, I choose to serve the Lord. And so you can see from these two scenarios that God is not imposing his will on us. He allows us to choose to get along with his plans. But his great desire is that we will fall into his plans. Then the Bible talks about remarrying. If there was one particular person meant for you to marry, then I don't think this issue of remarrying will surface anywhere in the Bible, because the Word of God says that for the widows and widowers who feel like they want to remarry, they are permitted to remarry. And so if there was one particular person meant for you, then it automatically means that once your spouse dies, then you're out of the game. There's no one else who is supposed to marry you or get married to you. And it will mean that if you remarry, then you're actually marrying someone else's spouse because yours already died. Yeah. But when we get to the point where the Bible is talking about remarrying, then it simply means you're not limited to just one person in your lifetime that you should marry. Then thirdly is the issue of eunuchs. The Bible tells us that others were called to be eunuchs. Look at this, then it will mean that from the argument of the rib, the Adam and Eve story, then it will mean that if me as a woman decide to be a eunuch, then it means my Adam somewhere will never marry or will always be looking for me, thinking that I'll be available for marriage, yet I've already offered myself to be a eunuch. Let's get to the conclusion of the matter. We've seen the two sides, and it's quite obvious that there's no such a thing as that one person meant for you to marry. Then there are also people that feel stuck in their marriages, that they think that if they missed it at the point of marriage because they feel like their marriages are going through trouble or just some misunderstanding because they didn't marry that particular person, the person. Marriage is an institution that is ordained by God, and so we can only rely on Him to lead us. Look at Eliezer. He relied on God to lead him to find a wife for Isaac. And in Isaiah 34:16, the word of God says that none shall lack a mate, and the Spirit of God shall gather them. So we can only rely on the leading of the Holy Spirit. There are many people that have walked with God to an extent that God even revealed to them their spouse, that is, their women friends of mine, that God told them, your husband's name is so and so, and it came to pass. And even as much as God might not come out clearly and tell you your husband or your wife is so and so, God can reveal Himself through visions. He can reveal Himself through dreams. He can reveal Himself through His word, which is a very definite way to know the will of God. He can reveal Himself through prophecies and many other ways. Let us therefore be connected to know which way God is leading us into this institution of marriage. I believe this video has helped someone to bring clarity even in their walk towards marriage or even in their marriage. I wish to meet you in my next video, so ensure you subscribe and also give it a thumbs up. Thank you for watching to the end. Goodbye.